Romneschal Amber may be the right girl for Roma Pete, but he's risking the wrath of his own people by marrying an outsider.
My family don't want me to marry Romneschal. They want to keep the bloodline the same.
Pete's Roma family has unique wedding rituals, including paying dowries and arranged marriages. But Amber's family is choosing not to honor all of these traditions.
We was kind of shocked when we found out they wanted to get married. She grew up the Romney way. I don't even think she knows our language. She doesn't know any of our traditions, any of our rules.
And Amber's breaking the Gypsy rules in more ways than one.
Have a good day at work.
See ya.
Amber ain't like your really typical Gypsy girl, because usually they just stay at home and cook and clean. But Amber, she likes to be independent.
When I get married, I want to keep working so I can have extra money. Most Gypsy girls feel like they don't have to work. I don't feel like I have to work either, but I like to work. So I can have my own money and I can spend it how I want to.
Unlike other Gypsy brides, Amber is staying at school to finish her education.
I don't think it makes you less of a Gypsy girl to work or go to school. Hey, Kristen. To me, it's important. You don't want to be dumb. You want to know how to spell your name and do math, and you don't want to look stupid going into a bank trying to open a bank account.
She'll probably be one of the amongst the first Gypsy girls to graduate, so she's kind of excited about that.
Come get your clothes and phone.
With the wedding just days away, Mum and Amber are heading to Boston, where Amber's dream dress is being created by America's top Gypsy dress designer, Sondra Celli.
Oh, it looks gorgeous.
Unlike Roma Gypsies, whose wedding dresses are conservative, Romani Gypsies like their gowns bigger and blingier.
Amber is pretty much adamant about what she wants, and she has a trick up her sleeve.
Hi!
Oh my God, I'm nervous. Oh my gosh.
Wow.
I really wasn't sure how her reaction would be. She was actually pretty stunned.
Does it have enough?
Yeah.
You said loaded.
It's got 80,000 rhinestones, and that's all Swarovski crystal.
That's beautiful.
When I saw it, you know, it was perfect. And I knew everybody was gonna be excited and shocked.
I love it.
What's traditional about this dress for Amber is the bling. That is so typical of a Romneschal Gypsy dress. She's gonna have the most blinged out dress ever. When it hits the lights, it's going to go crazy.
That's beautiful.
Here we come.
Oh, wow. Really excited seeing her in her wedding dress. It was like a special moment, kind of like when she was first born. It's one of the best wedding dresses I've seen.
I was a little worried, but Pete will love it.
And Amber saved the biggest surprise till last.
Hey, girls, we need your help.
Mum, Sugar, has no idea what's coming.
Oh my God. That ain't the train, is it?
It goes on forever.
That's too pretty. I haven't seen nothing like it ever. I had no idea that Amber had asked for a train. It was really, really long.
Taking on the Gorgia world is tough enough, but Romneschal Gypsy Bride Amber has a rival Gypsy culture to contend with.
I feel sick, like nervous. Like I want to throw up.
It's just 24 hours until her wedding to Roma Gypsy fiancé Pete.
Why are you nervous?
Well, we have yet to see if your family likes me.
The couple is making the 550-mile journey to Indiana to hold the wedding ceremony near Pete's family home.
We went out of our way to come up to Indiana to try to get along with them, so we've done it for their benefit, not for ours.
What can you do?
Pete's family didn't make it to the asking. I hope and pray that they make it to the wedding. It's their son, they gotta come.
If my family don't come to the wedding, I'd be really you know? They shouldn't care, you know, who I marry, no matter what kind of Gypsy.
After a long drive, Pete, Amber, and her family arrive in time for the wedding rehearsal.
Can we have everybody come in and sit down, please?
But there's no sign of Pete's relatives.
Family's messed up, Pete.
Not good. I don't want to talk right now. I'm just upset.
He's mad, just like everybody else would be. That's his family, and your feelings shouldn't even be hurt over them. They're not worth it.
Okay, now we're ready.
But just when Pete's abandoned all hope, there's a last-minute arrival. Pete's mum has defied the rest of her family to be by her son's side.
I want to come be by my son at church because I love my son. He's my baby.
Okay, and then we're ready to start the wedding.
I'm very happy that my mother was there, you know. She loves me, and that's my mom, so she's going to stand by me.
She's one of us, too, now. They disowned him, and she disowned them.
She's a converted Romney.
Right. So on the morning of the wedding, it's kind of traditional that he'll come and demand his bride out, and then we'll go back to the church for the ceremony.
The knocking signifies the acceptance of the groom by the bride's family.
They're coming.
They're here! All right, they're ready. Here they come.
All right, here we go.
With his mom and his buddies by his side, Pete's ready to knock for his bride.
You want the bride? You need her.
You want this
one? Here you are.
According to Roma tradition, each female in the bride's family is offered up.
You want the bride?
They were banging on the door and kicking the door, and they were like, bang, bang.
You want this one?
And we were throwing the girls out one by one.
They really wanted that bride.
Pete's about to get more than he bargained for.
When I do it again, we want the bride.
But there's only one woman he's interested in.
Bride! He wants
her! I saw Amber. She looked gorgeous. You know, I couldn't explain it any better. The dress was magnificent.
Oh my God, be careful!
Once we get her out, you know, my mom has to spin her around three times.
Spin around for luck.
Dad, drop the car.
Despite a wedding reception missing over half its guests, Amber and Pete celebrate in style. Fortunately, Sugar's last-ditch effort pays off, and Pete's siblings have a change of heart.
I was so excited. My sisters turned up.
My dad didn't want us to go to the wedding that day.
But we did anyways.
A good thing happened. My brother got married. They're starting a new life together.
I'm shy. There's two people here.
Things are looking up, and the newlyweds enjoy their first dance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bride, Mrs. Davis.
According to Roma Gypsy tradition, the groom must then share a dance with his sisters.
On our weddings, there's a lot of traditions that go along with the weddings, and we take those very close. And we do them every time.
But sisters Laura and Ashley are still waiting to be asked.
Everything was going great, but I forgot one thing. That was to dance with my sister.
That really hurt my feelings. It was like our tradition didn't matter to them. So it was either get mad or get drunk. So I got drunk.
We're all supposed to dance.
Yeah, the bride and the groom.
Yeah. See, but he wants to do it. Romney style. See, Romney style. That's the way we do it.
Don't mix it all.
So all you can call is a half breed. That's what she's. That's what their kids are gonna be. Is a half breed.
Sister's really upset. Yeah, she wanted that.
Well, she said so.
Now she's upset.
I want every gypsy to see that.
Sisters was so upset that they called their brothers down. That's when everything happened.
Oh, this brother.
Pete's brothers turn up.
All I know is everybody's running out the door.
The families was hollering and screaming at each other.
They can all go to jail. Turn it off.
Next thing I know, my cousin Yui got jumped.
There's blood, and all I heard was, they hit me. They all hit me.
Three of the Davis boys jumped on Yui, my nephew.
Four times on them.
That tall showing with the thing. Lock him up, cuz.
The wedding day has turned into a disaster.
Then the cops arrive.
Time is over, fellas!
Certain family members disagree how we made the wedding, and they try to cause problems for us.
Usually nobody really fights at a Romanian wedding.
They didn't do it the right way.
I'm your